a deadly rampage rolling through the streets of Santa Monica. 11:52 a.m., the first 911 call, a man wearing all black clothing and tactical gear leaves this house. Inside, two victims believed to be the shooter's father and brother.
He was coming out of the house, the gate of the house across the street, and then I noticed that that house was on fire and thought he'd been firing into the house.
The gunman then jumped into a car, forcing the driver with him. Minutes later, he opened fire on a Santa Monica City bus. No deaths, thanks to a quick-thinking bus driver.
It happened right in front of me. I mean, I was in my car, and a guy on the left side of the street jumped out of a car with a big black gun and started blasting rounds at all of our cars and the buildings and the bus.
Then, just minutes after that, the gunman shot up a building at an intersection in Santa Monica, then forced his driver to take him to Santa Monica College, where the killing spree continued.
I heard a couple of gunshots, and someone came running into our office and told us that someone had a gun and to get out. And so I instinctively ran into the hallway, and when I got out there, I saw a gentleman dressed in all black.
The incident cut a mile-long deadly path through the heart of Santa Monica, from the house that was set on fire to the library at Santa Monica College, packed with students studying for finals.
He just looked like he was standing there posing for the cover of an ammo magazine or something. It was really bizarre. Very calm, not running around, not yelling, just looking around for targets very casually.
Less than 15 minutes after it started, it was over. Four victims and the gunman dead.
The officers came in and directly engaged the suspect, and he was shot and killed on the scene.
His body moved from the library and taken to a sidewalk, where he was finally pronounced dead.